Mystery Favor Blessing Is My Name. Sinach featuring Israel Houghton fading out there. Bring us to exactly 12, actually 14 minutes, 15 now, minutes after 12. But Santi Sana for keeping it right here. And our guest that we have been waiting for is here. Karibu Sana Bishop.
Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah.
Amen. It's good to have you.
It's good to be here.
Yes.
And I bless the Lord for his grace and his mercy. And may the Lord help us as Kenyans.
Amen.
I was seated literally in Ngara for 2 hours.
Oh, pole
sana. And not because of police. It's just basic bad manners overlapping.
We have.
Yani mazee tuna overlap. Yani, mm-hmm. As in for two. Can you imagine 2 hours? How much?
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I'm just wondering. Mazee. Mm-hmm. Polisi wetu.
Mm-hmm.
There are people who are doing what is right.
Yes.
Kwa nini tunabembeleza wale wanavunja sheria? Hapo Ngara, today was an opportunity for the government to mm-hmm. generate money from these overlappers.
Oh.
Tulipe hizo maloan tukonazo kama gava.
Very true.
Hao watu wa deadly basi pia walipe mafine. Jumaze mm-hmm. wanatuka kwa barabara.
Mm-hmm.
Literally 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
I was listening to you way before 11.
Yes.
And way after 11, in fact, I had given up.
Oh,
I was actually on my way to church. And
but
then
we
I figured,
thank God for making a way.
I'm a watcher to nijaribu.
Asante. Asante sana.
God, buona sifu.
Amen.
Hey, now, polisi wetu mazee kaeni chonjo. Wanatusumbua bana. Washikeni tu.
I think Kenyans, we have a habit of doing that. We like overlapping. We are impatient.
Yeah, it's just wrong.
Yeah.
It's just wrong. Ni kutumiwa na shetani mazee. Na watu, na wengine wameokoka mazee.
Very true.
Wengine labda hata ni mapasi ama madikon. Shame on you. Okokeni. Salvation is by works.
Amen.
Si kusema tu ati umeokoka.
Mm-hmm.
Iwe na actions.
Actions.
Faith without works is dead.
It's dead. Very true.
It's very embarrassing.
Mm-hmm.
Ati unaona jamaa ameovalap alafu huko ameka bumper sticker ni Mungu. Mungu mgani? Okoka ndugu.
Oh, Fasi. It's good to have you. Thank you so much for being here.
Asifiwe Mwokozi.
Amen.
True church.
True church. So today you're talking about true church. Quite a number of people are excited. When we posted that you're coming,
yes.
A lot of people were really excited, waiting to hear. What mamesha eka hapo, hashtag wisdom, they're waiting to hear from you. And of course, what God has dropped in your heart. But possibly before we even start, you can tell us, you can, just a brief introduction. Tunakujua. But a brief introduction, who you are. You a family man, you're a bishop, umeniambia church ni
KAG, Kenya Assemblies of God.
Yes. Yeah, so kindly just give us that brief introduction. Yeah.
Okay, my name is Tony Kema,
mm-hmm.
And I'm born again, Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior. I've been saved for 30 years, mazi.
Wow.
Since 94, even me are shocked. Antinini. Just
yes.
The other day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm married. I've mm-hmm. been married for 26 years to Caro. Mm-hmm. We have 3 boys, mm-hmm. and Caro is also a pastor. We work together. We serve together at River of God.
Yes.
Which is in Parklands on Ojijo Road. That's mm-hmm. where we are.
Mm-hmm.
As I said earlier, it's a KAG congregation.
Yes.
And River of God, or ROG stands for River of God.
River of God, yes.
Yeah, and it's interesting because the founding pastor,
mm-hmm.
was given that name years before he came from Malaysia,
mm-hmm.
because this church was planted by a Malaysian missionary,
okay.
called Tony Pang, and mm-hmm. his wife Christine. And so it's interesting, they had no idea there was a river underneath.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
yeah,
there is a river,
and there's actually a river under River of God.
Wow,
bonus for you,
amen.
Yeah, so I have 3 sons, mm-hmm. and two in campus, one in Bible school, one doing economics. And then we have a little man
mm-hmm.
called Thayo. He's currently in school.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think that's it. And I bless the Lord for his grace.
Amen. There's something I noticed about your introduction.
Yes.
You didn't say pastor. You said Tony Kema.
Yeah, because I think it's at that point, first of all, before when you come before the Lord,
mm-hmm.
There's no title. It's just Tony Kiama, who's born again.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it, because that's where it starts.
Yes.
Yeah. And then all bishops, apostles, whoever, we are all pastors.
Mm-hmm.
Ministers of the gospel. It's a privilege and an honor. And yeah, I am ordained, so mm-hmm. I'm a reverend. And I sit in the council of bishops mm-hmm. within the Kenya Assemblies of God.
Mm-hmm.
I don't lead a jurisdiction, I mean, like a district like Nairobi or whatever. I head a national department,
wow.
KAG Media,
mm-hmm.
and I'm the chairman of the board of AG Housing. So wow. by virtue of that, I mm-hmm. sit in that. I'm privileged to sit in the council of bishops by appointment, not by election.
Wow.
So, kwa neema na huruma jamani.
Ni kwa neema.
Na huruma nyingi.
I like the fact that you have pointed that out.
Yes.
Mungu ametuhurumia. We take that for granted.
Hey.
So today we are talking about the true church. As you were waiting uko kwa jam, I decided to ask people to tell me.
I had.
Oh, you kustia. Did. Yeah. Yes, and several people were saying about, you know, the church is the identity of Christ. The church is Bible-believing, teaching, you know, the truth.
Those are the characteristics of a church.
Oh, okay. Now, kindly help us define what is a true church.
First of all, we start with what is church?
Mm-hmm. Mm.
What is church? Church is a body of believers. And church is in threefold.
Mm-hmm.
The church is the building
mm-hmm.
Where believers meet followers of Christ. Mm-hmm. In Acts 11, in Antioch, the believers were first called Christians.
Yes.
Because they were following after Christ.
Mm-hmm.
So church is a group of people, is where those Christians, believers who follow after Christ,
yes,
gather for worship.
Mm-hmm.
Now that is church.
Yes.
But also church
mm-hmm.
is a body of believers.
Mm-hmm.
We are the church of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Without building, we are a church.
Mm-hmm.
And the church of Jesus Christ is universal, is global.
Yes.
And when I say universal, I don't mean the Roman Catholic Church.
Yes.
Yeah. But that is also the church of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
As in, we are the church of Jesus Christ. And then you as an individual are part of the church.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the word church translated into English
mm-hmm.
is ecclesia.
Mm-hmm.
This is a Greek word.
Mm-hmm.
There's also a Greek word called kaleo. It comes from the word kaleo.
Yes.
And kaleo means to be called.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a prefix to it,
mm-hmm.
ek or ek,
mm-hmm.
Which means out. So we are the called out, ones as
mm-hmm.
ecclesia. We are the called
out ones.
And we have been called out of the world, though we are still in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And that's however, the word church doesn't necessarily appear in the Greek,
mm-hmm.
but it's a word that we use today that defines ecclesia.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to also say that it is important for us to remember that Shakespeare said, any fool in error
mm-hmm.
can find a verse in the Bible to first support their folly.
Oh, yeah.
Or their foolishness.
And there are many who have done that.
Exactly.
Yes.
Now, there are many churches out there.
Mm-hmm.
And they sing Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And I keep telling most believers today,
mm-hmm.
we have a responsibility before you walk into any church to mm-hmm. find out what is their statement of faith. What do they believe in? Because there are many people out there who are mm-hmm. saying Jesus, they are singing all the other songs that everyone else is,
mm-hmm.
and they are using the Bible.
Yes.
But that doesn't necessarily mean they're the true church.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I think it is careless.
Mm-hmm.
And there are maybe 90% of the believers today have
mm-hmm.
no idea
mm-hmm.
what their church believes in. For example, there are many people who say, you know me, I was born an Anglican, but they
mm-hmm.
have no idea
mm-hmm.
what the Anglican church believes in. What's their statement of faith? There are many mm-hmm. people who call themselves Catholics or even KAG.
Yes.
Or even Sitamites,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but they have no idea what your statement of faith is.
Yes.
And I think it's extremely careless
wow.
for you to walk into a church and not know what mm-hmm. they believe in, so that you can append your signature and say,
mm-hmm.
I agree with what they believe in
mm-hmm.
and I am part of it
mm-hmm.
and I am willing to propagate this statement of faith,
yes.
this truth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there are many people who you go to a church and you actually don't believe in what they believe in.
Mm-hmm.
And later on is when, you know, like when the scales fall, you realize, Allah, I was in a cult.
Oh.
But you had no idea. Or
mm-hmm.
even later on,
mm-hmm.
when you realize that these people actually, in fact, what you believe in, they actually don't believe in it.
Mm-hmm.
Let me give you an example.
Yes.
Jesus was baptized
mm-hmm.
by immersion or through immersion.
Yes.
True?
Yes.
When you go to chapter 8, you see the Ethiopian eunuch.
Mm-hmm.
They are walking, going back to Ethiopia from the Middle East.
Yes.
Philip is sent to him, mm-hmm. and he's reading the book of Isaiah. And mm-hmm. at one point, he asks himself, I have believed. Mm-hmm. Why shouldn't I be baptized?
Yes.
Exactly. And if, since it's a very important ordinance, why don't you just dip your fingers into a cup and mm-hmm. draw a cross on your head? And since you're in the middle of a desert, and be baptized,
mm.
why is it necessary for the Bible to declare, to record to us
mm-hmm.
that they walk, as they were riding, mm-hmm. the eunuch asked for the chariot to stop.
Mm-hmm.
And they walked out of the chariot
mm-hmm.
and they saw a pool of water. And the Bible says they walked into
mm-hmm.
the pool of water.
Yes.
Yeah, you can't walk into a cup.
No.
Bonus,
you can't. Amen.
Yeah. So they walked into this pool of water. Mm-hmm. And the Bible says that he was baptized. And afterwards, he was they walked out, as in it goes into the detail of explaining that they got in
mm-hmm.
and they got out. Why? Mm-hmm. Because it's an important, it's a critical part of the Christian faith.
Mm-hmm.
Because baptism is publicly declaring that I am born again, I am dead to self. Because baptism is mm-hmm. baptizo, being buried.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that when you come out, it is no longer you that live, but mm. Christ that lives
in you.
Mm-hmm. It's symbolic, yes, but it's important because even Jesus did it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of course, not because he was a sinner, mm-hmm. but to fulfill all righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you walk into a church and mm-hmm. 50% or maybe 70% of Christendom today
mm-hmm.
don't believe in the baptism as prescribed in scripture.
Mm-hmm.
They don't believe in biblical baptism.
Yes.
They've coined their own baptism.
Mm-hmm.
Unachorwa kamsalaba kwa kichwa, unatumwagiliwa tumaji kwa kichwa,
yeah.
Hey, unasalimia bishop, unapita chini ya flag. Yani madness iko kila mahali. And that's mm-hmm. why I keep saying, let's kick nonsense out of the Church of Jesus Christ. Turudi tu kwa neno.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, there are many people today who go to a church
mm-hmm.
or who even hold a baptism certificate that is not biblical.
Mm-hmm.
And so you ask yourself, sincerely speaking, ni aje? Yani you are so duped. Yani fakeness.
Mm-hmm.
Mbaka ile document umebeba ni fake.
But see, I think it's because a lot of people don't read the Bible. You know, you have just given us several details. You know, Jesus was baptized, Philip baptized the Ethiopian eunuch. A lot of people don't read the Bible. So they trust the pastors.
So the true church is Christ-centered.
Mm-hmm.
Because Jesus is the church.
Mm-hmm.
And the church is his bride.
Yes.
So he will come back for his bride. So mm-hmm. the church must be Christ-centered.
Like, yes.
Yeah, it must be Christ-centered, not man-centered. And mm-hmm. so we are, in the recent past, removing the power of God.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the power from the name of Jesus Christ, the name that is above every other name, the name at which all of us are born again.
Yes.
To things.
Mm-hmm.
Let me give you an example.
Yes.
Shenanigans nazo. Mambo kuuza maji.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi naweza taka mtu anionyeshe scripture mm-hmm. ile mtu aliuziwa maji.
Mm-hmm.
Na kuna mapasi wa deadly huko Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Wanauzaga maji. Maji. Nionyeshe Bible mahali maji iliuzwa.
Hakuna.
Hizo ni nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
Na bado unapata watu tu wanafuata makondoo ndio hizo. Na sisi wote ni kondoo.
Mm-hmm.
But I think kuna kondoo jinga kuliko zingine.
Very true.
Eh, hey, juu. Si first usome Bible uone hakuna mahali Yesu aliuzia mtu maji.
Mm.
Maji ilikuwa ya kubatiza. Sasa wewe
yes.
ushaekewa kwa chupa
mm-hmm.
na ukauziwa so ama so mbili ama so. Yaani mnagongwa mm-hmm. live mkiona.
Mm-hmm.
Na mnagongwa mkiambiwa Yesu, Yesu, Yesu. Huyo si shetani.
Mm-hmm.
Unauziwa chumvi.
Mm-hmm.
Unauziwa handkerchief. Unauziwa mafuta. As in, mm-hmm. sasa hizi ndio gani? Hizi sasa ndio gani unauziwa mafuta
mm-hmm.
na unanunua aje
yes.
Mungu atusamehe tu. So even as we are talking about church,
yes.
it must be Christ centered and let's not bring shenanigans
mm-hmm.
into the Church of Jesus Christ, because the purpose for the church
mm-hmm.
is to fulfill the purpose, the true Church of Christ
mm-hmm.
the true church is to fulfill the purposes of God. And number one, Jesus came to seek and save the lost
mm-hmm.
for the redemption of man. He
yes.
came so that he can pay for our sins
mm-hmm.
so that our life, as in it's a life for a life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Since for you to get life, you have to give life.
Yes.
So Jesus died instead of me, and you and every one of us.
Yes.
So those who accept Christ, mm-hmm. then they have life. Number two, so that we can be like Christ. Mm-hmm. So the church of Jesus Christ, the true church is the church of Jesus Christ, and it should look like Christ.
Yes.
It should live like Christ. It mm-hmm. should talk like Christ. It mm-hmm. should behave like Christ. It should handle itself like Christ. And the instructions have been given in scripture.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You don't need a new revelation. Na squeezy kuna machache za new dimension, new revelation. There's no revelation outside of the current word of God.
Very true.
Yeah. God has already revealed himself, number one, through scripture,
mm-hmm.
through the Holy Spirit and himself. Mm-hmm. In John chapter 1 and verse 14, he became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen him, mm-hmm. full of grace and truth.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's in that sense that we need to remember that we are redeemed,
mm-hmm.
atoned for, our sins are paid for, damu ilimwagwa.
Yes.
Number two, we need to be like Jesus Christ.
Mm.
And number three, mm-hmm. we need to be a witness,
yes.
for Christ.
Mm-hmm.
We need to share Christ with the world.
Mm-hmm.
And so that brings me to the second point.
Yes.
The church of Jesus, the true church should be a mission church.
Oriented, okay.
Mm-hmm. It should be a mission going church.
Mm-hmm.
As in missions is the heartbeat of God.
Very true.
Na bishop wa sita msaai, ukimkata hivi mkono, ukata hivi damu.
Mm-hmm.
Bishop Kalisto, missions ndio zitamwagika.
Kweli.
Juu yeye ni wa missions.
Mm.
Lakini sasa hivi tumefika mahali kwa makanisa.
Mm-hmm.
Unapata church iko na missions department because you have a special breed of people who go on mission, not the whole church. Mpaka tuko na pasi wa missions. Juu kuna mapasi wengine waendage missions. Au ni wa deadly. Au ni wa kukaa kwa ofisi. Absolute nonsense. Sisi wote ni wa kuenda missions. Mm-hmm. Missions si ya watu wengine na wengine.
Mm-hmm.
Church yote iende mission, si yes. wengine.
Mm-hmm.
Unakaa kwa church. Sijui kama huku kwenyu ni kama kwetu. Unapata mazee ma V8 na manini na maprado na na hazijawahi enda mission.
Mm-hmm.
Yet ni gari za kuenda huko inje. Mm-hmm. To seek and save the lost. Because the true church is a mission
oriented church.
Oriented church. Mm-hmm. Lakini unapata in an entire congregation, unapata pastoral team kuna mapasta kama waine ama watano ama 10, however, mm-hmm. depending on your financial capacity.
Mm-hmm.
Lakini pastor wa missions ni mmoja. Wengine unapata maze, wewe ni senior pastor, mwaka inaisha 365 days na ujawai enda mission, na wewe ni pasi. Sema fakeness.
Wow.
Yet Jesus mm-hmm. called, the church is actually the called out ones,
mm-hmm.
so that we can go out.
Yes.
Lakini sasa nyinyi mmekelea hiyo mzigo yote kajamaa kamoja.
Kamoja
pale. Na chances are he's not even the most paid pastor.
Yeah, some of them don't even have cars.
Shame on us. So tunarushaga kajamaa hapo kakuweka missions.
Mm-hmm.
Juu church hazina hata vision ya missions. No wonder Jesus has come back. Why? Because we are not going out there.
Mm-hmm.
We are not a witness. Mm-hmm. We are not a mission-oriented church. And so the true church must be mission-oriented.
Mm-hmm.
Na hizi stories ati tukona pasi wa missions. Ni kila mtu and missions.
Mm-hmm.
Ni kama, by the way, let me tell you a short story. When I became a senior pastor,
yes,
I had purpose in my heart.
Mm-hmm.
My sister, that number one,
mm-hmm.
akuta kuwa.
Mm-hmm.
Now I know this will rub a few people the wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
Sitakuwa na waombezi.
Au utakuwa na intercessors?
No intercessors.
Mm-hmm.
Me had purposed in my heart as a youth pastor for 10 years. I had purposed. God, the day you make me a senior pastor, the first group of people I'll fire is intercessors. And for sure, the day I became a senior pastor, I fired them.
Mm-hmm.
Kwa sababu, ni nani hawa God alikol waombe na wengine wasiombe? Mm. So sa nyinyi msikuage mnaomba juu kuna intercessors au ndio wanatuombeaga au ndio wanatubebeaga mzigo wa maombi. Nyinyi mnajibamba tu kuna mabaga na masembe. Wengine wafungage, si ndio? Mnaumiza watoto wengine ndio wabebe spiritual burdens zenyu.
Oh.
Wacheni niwaambie, sisi River of God hakunaga mm-hmm. intercessors.
Everyone is an
kila mtu aombe.
Yes.
Kama ujue hivi.
Mm-hmm.
Kama uombi, hakuna mtu anakuombea. Because God, kila mtu wabebe msalaba yake.
Okay. Yes.
So if you are looking for a church, mm-hmm. River of God might not be the one for you. If mm-hmm. you are not a man of prayer. Na ukikuja huko, ujue huko, hakunaga intercessors. Ni kila mm-hmm. mtu ajiombe. Si ati hapa, ati unajua tu church yetu ina intercessors wa deadly. Na weza unasema hivyo. Nikumanga unabanga hapa kanyama. Wanaombaga majee. Our mother wanakuwa kwa wamefinyika ni vile wanatuombea. Nonsense. Mm. Kila mtu aombe.
Yes.
Eh. Mm. Ukitoa my intercessors, kila mtu ataomba.
Very true.
Eh. Mm. Because prayer, the Bible says, in Thessalonians, pray without ceasing.
Mm-hmm.
And every one of us must pray. Why? Because prayer is an integral part of the true church. But let me tell you something, my sister. Look at our least attended prayer meetings in church. Our prayer meetings.
Prayer meetings, yeah.
Which is even worse. Pastors don't show up. And we are supposed to be leading from the front. Enda katoloni uone ni mabishopu wangapi utapata huko wakifunga wakiomba. Osha kuwa deadly. Tushakuwa deadly. No wonder the church is going south. No wonder the church is going
south. Yes.
That's why we have 400 plus graves in Kilifi. Human sacrifice in a church. And no one is saying nothing. And something that has been carrying my heart is LGBTQ. Maze, there were principles in Mombasa a year and a half ago. And the principals were saying, it is no longer economically viable to kick out children who practice homosexuality and lesbianism in our schools because they become too many. It's a serious problem in our boarding schools. And the question for me is this. Why haven't all the bishops in this country called a press conference and condemned LGBTQ nonsense on a national platform? You know why they wouldn't do that? Because if they do that, their American visas will be revoked. Their visas for the UK will be revoked. For Europe will be revoked. You know why? Because they will be considered homophobic. And because of that, they wouldn't condemn it. So they are selling the soul of our children to the enemy for the sake of money. Watching it walk okay. The God of Sodom and Gomorrah still lives.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
Uyo bado yuko.
And
I'm telling you, the true church condemns evil.
Very
declare
true.
Sin is sin. Squeezy maze. On weddings. When was the last time you had a wedding imesimamishwa kwa sababu mujamaa walikuwa na bumburushana na mudem before harusi? Fornication is still a sin.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Sex before marriage is still sin.
Yes.
But when was the last time you had it preached in church?
Hardly.
Exactly. So, it doesn't exist. So, even when they are walking down the aisle, in absolute sin. And the pastor is there laughing. Kwa nini amelambishwa kakitu? Juwezi fanyiwa harusi kwa kanisa bure. So we are more interested in shillings and cents than in the souls of men and women. So we are no longer telling them the truth. So the truth is no longer preached in church. If there's a place where truth is not found, is in church. How sad. And the church of Jesus Christ, the true church, speaks the truth.
Very.
Yeah, but yeah, truth is rare. Divorce. The Bible, if there are several things that God says he hates, one of them is divorce.
Divorce, yes.
Maze, it's right, left, and center in church. I love the Bible is very, very clear. If you divorce, you don't remarry. How many marriages, how many people are remarrying who are divorced in our churches? On the altars. Na bado mnasema hizo ni true church. Uko ni ikabod, God alinyorosha. Alitusari, tuko alone.
Pasi, you're very right.
Isn't it nonsense?
Pastor, there is something I'd like to ask before we go, yeah? You mentioned the very first thing you said, ulisema, that the true church is the church of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
So we are like, we are the true church if we behave the way Jesus Christ behaved.
Yes.
There's something
Christ-like.
I've heard people talk about tithe.
Yes.
I know Atawo Meskia. And there's a time Jesus was asked about tithe and he clearly said, give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar and what
belongs to God, God, give to God.
Give to God.
Yeah.
But there are a lot of people who are, tithing is just one, but there are a lot of people coming up with things saying that is in the Old Testament.
Unajua nini?
Fanya
vile unataka. Si mimi unanyorosha. The Bible says when you don't pay tithe, you steal.
Yes.
So wewe ukiona utaendelea kuiba.
Kwani
ni mimi unaibia?
Hapana.
Sini Jehova. Utangangana na yeye.
Kwenda
huko. Kwani unadhani hiyo pesa yako ndio inatulishaga daily? Wewe tithe yako ndio imefanya church ikatoka kule ilitoka in the Middle Ages mpaka saa hii. If Jesus tarries for another 1,000 years, tithe yako ndio ita sustain church for the next 1,000 years.
No.
Kaa nayo. Kwani ni ngapi?
Si mingi.
Endelea kuiba. Na hope umekula ukashiba kabisa. Nini hii? Jehovah alisema vizuri. Pay your tithe. Even in the New Testament, it's there. And yes, so yes. Jesus alisema, give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar and to God what is God's. Nini hii tunabishana hapa ati tithe? Sikubembelezi utoe. Yeah. Kama utai kutoa kaa. Unapatia Jehovah na ukosa kumtolea pia. Umuibie, niye unaibia si mimi. Ukitoa tithe, by the way, si pastor unapatia, ni Jehovah.
Ni Jehovah, it's God.
Na yeye pastor akipewa, ajue hiyo pesa ni ya Jehovah. Akijibamba nayo pia, Jehovah bado ni moto ulao. So sijui tunabembelezana nini. Wewe ukao unaona utai kutoa. Si ni zako?
Yes.
Hizo chapaa ni zetu ama ni zako? Ni zako. Kaa nazo.
Wow.
Tunabishana nini kama utaki kutoa? Why are you making it public? It's a private affair. Tithe is between you and God. Why are you complaining here? Oh, it was in the news. Kama unaona hivyo basi unapiga kelele ya nini? Si ukatae tu kutoa na unyamaze. Unataka kutuambia ndio tujue wewe ni mdeadly kiasi gani. Acha ufala. Pesa ni yako. Kama utai kutoa, kaa nayo. Si ni iko kwa mfuko yako? Ni nani unaibia pasi?
Hapana.
Unaibia Jehovah.
Jehovah. Pasi will go for a very brief break.
Asifiwe Mwokozi.
Amen. I can see quite a number of people. There's someone here who's saying, Andrew Miner is saying, this man is on another level. Unscripted, radical, the Paul Washer of Kenya. What he speaks is unpalatable to today's diplomatic chat. I'll be surprised if he never gets invited again. We'll invite you again and again, Pasi. Why? Because we want to know the truth. And I'm glad that there's someone who is speaking, you know, unapologetically and telling us some of the things. You know, some of the things you have said, I've never considered
Jesus
them.
Jesus called them whitewashed tombs and brood of vipers. Aliwaita nyoka. Mbia tazijawaita mtu nyoka.
Apana.
Yesu aliwaita manyoka. Whitewashed tombs.
Na wengine akawaita fox.
The gospel is offensive.
Very true.
The gospel is offensive.
So we go for a short break. When you come back, Pasi is going, I'm going to read out some of the comments and the questions and see if Pasi will finish. Pasi atakuja siku ingine kumaliza. Sindio, Bishop?
Asifiwe Mwokozi.
Yes, you. Yes, so we go for a short break. We'll be back in a short while.
The Afternoon Switch with Man Karis. Conversations on issues affecting the young people.
So what happened? Pale unastruggle na wimbo za church, na mtu umependa reggae, reggae tunde na rinko kichwa yako, what do you do?
Ningetaka kusema garbage in, garbage out. Kile una feed, ndicho utakuwa, una hata ukilala ukiota, kile una feed ndiyo kinacheza kwa akili yako.
And this fire kept on burning in me. And at some point, I saw myself and I told God, the day nitajisikia nikimba kwa hiyo radio.
The Afternoon Switch with Man Karis, weekdays from 1 p.m.
Listen and live on 93.3 FM in Nairobi, 93.9 Western Kenya, and 101.9 Mombasa.
Believe that the sky is the highest thing in life, but I believe it's just the highest thing they've seen. Well, you better believe there's someone beyond that big blue thing. He's the biggest, greatest thing, the biggest, greatest thing I've never seen. It's been said there's nothing deeper than the ocean's deep. But could it be that's just too far for the human mind to think? But I know someone more intelligent than words can speak. And he's the biggest, greatest thing, the biggest, greatest thing I've never seen. The moral of the story is,
someone that's definitely bigger, greater than you might think. I know that you are wondering if everything we're saying here is make-believe, but it's reality. And if you look around, he's everywhere to be found, but he's the biggest, greatest thing.
Yes, and we cannot wait to see his face. Quite a number of your comments and your contributions. Asante sana. I'm going to sample a few before Bishop. I'm calling him Pastor, but he's actually a Bishop. Bishop Tony Kiama comes to tell us more. Esther Mbele is saying, hi, Shiko and Bishop, watching and ready to learn. I see Ogola. You're saying, say hi to my Bishop, listening to him. Quite a number. Lucy Motue is saying, I love what he's teaching. Anwambo, you're saying, we bless the Lord for you, Bishop. Kwa kuitikia mwito, you say it as it is without sugarcoating anything. Wazi pasi. On WhatsApp, I have somebody saying, hello, Bishop and Sister Shiko. And they're asking a question. They're asking a question according to Matthew 12 and 40.
Let me get there.
Some anasema, for Jonas was 3 days and 3 nights. It was the whole...
Yes.
Yeah.
Matthew 12.
And then
12 and 40. Anatakaje?
Anauliza, okay. Has this prophecy, okay, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth?
See, that already happened. He already died and he rose again.
Oh, yes, yeah. Yes.
He's
asking, has this prophecy been?
Yes. Easter.
Mm-hmm.
That's what happened over Easter.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the essence of Easter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he prophesied and he died.
Yes.
And he was in the belly, he was buried in the belly of the earth for 3 days, Friday, Saturday, and yes, he resurrected on Sunday.
Yes.
Buenas fear.
Amen.
Yeah. So it's been fulfilled in Jesus' name.
Amen. Someone else, I think this is the last one I'm going to sample. You're saying, I love the passion of the man of God. I pray that this information sinks in our heart, that we may practice this. Najua ofe, I asked Pastor Kama, there are people who usually come, Pastor, please pray for me, you know.
You know, my sister.
Yes.
When you come and tell me to pray for you.
Yes.
Ndakuombea, lakini the question for me is this. Sayo ndakuwa naomba, wewe utakuwa unafanya?
Mm-hmm.
Eh, ndakuombea lakini tuende tuombe na wewe.
Yes.
Eh. Mm. Si ati mimi ndimeenda kuomba na wewe umeenda kujivinjari.
Mm.
Hapana.
Mm-hmm.
Tuende tuombe sisi wote.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Eh. Tuende tuombe sisi wote.
Yes.
Ministry ni tano.
Mm.
Prophet, apostle,
mm-hmm,
pastor, teacher na evangelist.
Mm-hmm.
Hakuna ya sita.
Hakuna.
Hakuna ya muombezi. Hakuna.
Yeah.
Ni tano. Ni sisi wote tukutane at the foot of the cross.
Mm-hmm.
And the ground at the foot of the cross is level.
Mm-hmm.
It's for all of us. Come as you
come are.
As you are. The curtain door.
Mm-hmm.
Hata kani LGBT we kuja hivyo. Mm-hmm. God has the power to transform you.
Yes.
Buona sifiwe.
Amen.
Come as
you are.
There is room at the bot at the foot of
the cross. Yes.
Hapo hakuna mtu mdeadly. Hakuna bank balance.
Mm. Wow. I think what I like about this is the fact that it will help Christians to work out their own
salvation with fear and trembling.
Yes.
In fact, let me ask you, my sister.
Yes.
Why would the Lord say, work out your salvation with fear and trembling?
Because
what is there to be fearful about? Why should you tremble in fear?
Mm-hmm.
Because God is still a consuming
fire.
Mm-hmm. But you see, the two times that Christianity is up there,
mm-hmm,
one is Jesus hanging on a cross helpless.
Mm-hmm.
So we assume he's still there.
Mm-hmm.
Altoka msalabani. Mm-hmm. And I know 45 or 50% of Christendom still sells, you know, crosses with Jesus hanging on that cross. He's no longer on the cross.
He rose again. Wapendwa,
Yesu altoka msalabani. He's seated on the right hand of the Father and he'll come on a horse.
Yes, yes.
He's a commander of the armies of heaven.
Mm-hmm.
He's to be feared. That's
yes,
why the Bible is saying, work out your salvation with fear and
trembling.
Trembling.
Yes.
Yeah. tuogope huyu Mungu.
Oh, it's the gospel of grace that has made us to nonsense, take him lightly.
Eh, now that there's grace, we go on. Should we continue on sinning?
No.
The answer is no.
Mm-hmm.
And that scripture still stands.
Very true.
Why should we tremble in fear? And that's how we should work out our salvation. God is to be feared. Tuogope dhambi wapendwa. And there's grace because he says our righteous man falls 7 times. Mm. He wakes up and moves on. He doesn't remain there.
Very true.
Yeah. Na hii neema ndio inaendelea ndio sababu fornication has become what describes church. And that's why the youth man or the youth hawataki kuja church. Juu wakituangalia nje wanaona sasa kanisa na dunia ni the same. Eh. Wa maboy huku na mademu wanabingirishana mbaya na hakuna kitu ina happen. Wanaenda kwa altar the same. As in, it's the same as in sin is like a handshake in church. No one ever speaks about it. And one of the challenges is because people who live in glass houses don't throw stones. So the deacon will not hold the pastor accountable because the deacon also doesn't want the pastor to hold him
accountable. Yeah.
Staki nikuulize hii gari ulinunua na nini na ulitoa pesa wapi? Let me ask you a question. If truly the church in Kenya is a true church, corruption should have ended a long time ago.
Yes.
Especially Kwanzaa right now that the government is a church, is a government of God. There should be zero
tolerance,
zero
yeah.
corruption kwa serikali ya Mungu, si ndio? Sasa nataka uniambie wale vijana wako huko nje, wametoka university, wapi, huko mamtaani wamekalia mawe, wanajua serikali ya Mungu around hii hata makarao hata dungu wa mafinje finje. Jumzae.
But it still is happening.
Yeah. Praise ni chali wa God. Alikama ameshikilia Biblia. Lakini my friend, tunaona na meno. Karao wanachukua mbaya. Au watu wa huku mazee masies. In 9 months, wote walikuwa na mahau Karen. Who's fooling who? As in seriously?
Yes.
What? As in for sure, the true church. We are just describing it. But does a true church exist in this country?
No.
Yeah.
And even if it exists, the fear of God may...
Ilishia. And you see, the church, the true church of God is driven by the fear of God. It is evident.
Yes.
Ah, watu, bado wanatoa sadaka kanisani. Some of these CSs are elders in churches. Na kwa hizo chacha tujawahi sikia ati pasi amekasirika nao wameleta chapaka wafukuza na hiyo pesa. Saa hii madaktari wa on strike. Na it all boils down to shillings and cents. Yani gava imekula mpaka pesa ya dawa na mashindano. That's what these guys are complaining about. Yet mazi, because healthcare was devolved to the counties.
Yes.
Ebu angalia, kama sasa county ya Nairobi. Tunasikia mazee governors juu wamebuy mahao wapi, Dubai, juu magari zile wanapeleka. Gari madness. Na hosi hazina dawa. As in huku ni easy ndiyo gani. Na watu bado wanaendaga church.
Church gani?
Hizi chacha huenda. Ama pasi wamelambishwa hata hawezi ongea. I'm a bishop of the church. I think we need to come to a point where we audit every pastor. Tujue mzai, hii hao ya Karen ulitoa wapi? Hii V8 ulitoa wapi? Hata kama ni kavoki, wacha tuambie tu ukweli, hii dinga ulitoa wapi? Tuambiane ukweli. Let us hold them, let's hold each other accountable. But the reason why the church cannot hold government accountable is because church is as corrupt as the government. Hawa watu ni mategi na ni watumishi wa Mungu. Mungu atusamehe. Tuambiane ukweli.
Yes, yes.
Uwezi kuwa na V8 na children's church iko ndani ya tent.
It doesn't make sense.
Aje. Inamaanisha uli manga ya children's church ukabuy V8. Na bado watu waenda hiyo church. Na mnaona for sure huu pastor ni tag. Na bado mko tu. Church ni ya mabati lakini pastor yuko na how madness Karen. Hizo ndio gani? Which true church are we talking about here? Tuambiane ukweli, tu kick nonsense out of church.
Very true.
Wacheni tu, first of all, turudi pale basics. The true church is about salvation. wachini yes. tuokoke kwanza.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go back to being saved. Because hizi vitu watu wanafanya, hawajaokoka, waliwachana na Jehovah zamani. We shall know them by the fruit, my sister.
Very true.
An apple tree cannot produce lemons. Unless it's a lemon tree. If you see lemons on a tree, it's a lemon tree. It's not an apple tree. It's not. So hawa waliwachana na Jehovah zamani because they do not reflect Jesus in any way, form or kind.
Hawa
mm-hmm. Waliwachana na ye zamani. Bwana tusamehe. Wachungaji wacheni tuokoke.
Tuokoke.
Washirika pia waokoke.
Na tuseme ukweli.
Ili Kenya watu waokoke. Mm. Tuite dhambi. Dhambi.
Dhambi, yes.
Na tukemee LGBTQ. Because ule Mungu alimaliza Sodom na Gomora bado yuko.
Bado yuko.
Bado yuko. Na chuma yetu yuko motoni. Asifiwe Mwokozi.
Amen. You remind me of a scripture, Jeremiah. Mm. God talking to Jeremiah and saying, do not be afraid of them.
Yes.
Yes, do not be afraid of them. And I think as a children of God, we need to get to that point where we are not afraid of what people can do to us because our God, hata yeye ana, like you said, anaweza kupigania and he's a consuming fire.
He's a consuming fire.
So, Pasi, we only have 5 minutes.
Acha tuombe.
Yes.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that you will have mercy on us.
Yes.
And forgive us for we have sinned against thee. Jehovah, the Church of Jesus Christ today has become complacent. Tusamehe Mwenyezi Mungu. Naomba tu tusamehe. May we be a praying church.
Yes.
May we be a Bible believing church. May we be a church whose actions
mm-hmm.
are in tandem with the scripture.
Yes.
A church that is not afraid to say, I have sinned
mm-hmm.
and I ask for forgiveness.
Yes.
A church that is not bitter. A church that is faithful in giving. And Lord, a church that is mission-minded. That we will lead from the front as ministers of the gospel, Almighty God. That we will go on missions. We will not tell people to go like a signpost, but we will go and lead from the front. The Lord, our hearts will be consumed with winning souls. That it will break our hearts when people die in sin.
Yes.
Oh God. In your wrath, remember mercy. Remember mercy. And Lord, if there has been a sense of arrogance, I ask for forgiveness. And may you forgive us all. And here we are, use us. Thank you for Hope FM. And may your name continue to be exalted here and glorified in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen and amen. I think I'm just going to go through some of the messages. We have a bit, someone is saying, where the show is on fire. Someone else actually asked for prayer, saying, Pastor, I need prayer. We wedded in church, but the guy left and is cohabiting with another lady.
Pastor, he's only done begun.
Pray for God to sustain and to continue, to help me continue serving. Someone saying, Pastor, you have blessed me. Mwenye masikio, amesikia. Good afternoon, Shiko and Bishop Tony. We, napenda ukweli, tunanyorosha nayo. This is one, Mr. Cheniki. Someone else, really, really following and enjoying every bit of it, the raw, unedited truth. Pastor, someone is saying you need security, but I think God is able to to secure his own. Quite a number of people, Pasi, really appreciating what you're saying, people feeling ukweli, umetuambia ukweli. Mimi nilirisk nikaenda missions, wase huniona fala. Yeah, I think alienda peke yake, something like that. Quite a lot of people agreeing with what you're saying, Pastor. Thank you so much.
Amen.
May God bless you so much, Pastor. I think right now we only have a minute, maybe your parting shot.
Let us maintain holiness. God says, be holy mm-hmm. as I am
holy.
Holy.
Mm-hmm.
None of us is perfect.
No.
We don't go to heaven because we are perfect.
Very
we
true.
Go to heaven because we are born again.
Mm-hmm.
And if there's somebody listening to me right now
mm-hmm.
and would like to give your life to Jesus Christ, repeat these words. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Forgive my sin.
Forgive my sin.
And accept me.
and accept me
as your son or your daughter.
As your son and daughter or daughter.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. If you have prayed that prayer,
mm-hmm.
find a Bible-believing church. They are no perfect churches, by the way.
Yes.
They are no perfect churches. Just find a Bible-believing church.
Mm-hmm.
And as you walk in, ask for their statement of faith.
Yes.
Read it through.
Mm-hmm.
I wish we had a bit more time. I would have shared with you certain things that a true church should believe in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, believe in Jesus Christ, in his resurrection, in the death,
mm-hmm.
baptism by immersion,
mm-hmm.
You know, in Holy Communion.
Mm-hmm.
And,
but we will
and
have you back.
Things. Yes.
There's there several an opportunity. Other things. Yes.
At least I have a list of about 16. The millennial rule. There's quite a bit
okay.
of the true church, but Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
Tuishie Bwana.
Tuishie Bwana. Asante sana for coming, Bishop Tony. We really appreciate it. And thank you for speaking truthfully as God sent you.
Amen.
We can see one Tess ready to tell us some of the stories making headlines. For me, until tomorrow, same time, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., I leave you in her hands. Watch out for David King coming in the afternoon switch. God bless you.
And I'm sorry I came late.
It's okay, Pastor. Thank you.
Hope FM. It's now 1 p.m.
Listen and live. A revival.